Welcome to tonight's contest. Here are your Rochester High School varsity player.
I'm Luke Kennedy, number 40, and I'm a forward.
Alec Garrick, senior, number 24, forward.
I'm Brandon Camp, I'm a senior, and I'm a shooting guard.
I'm Carter Screen, I'm a senior, and I play point guard.
Brett Abbott, shooting guard, sophomore.
I'm Alec Holland, I'm a sophomore and a guard.
Matthew Bastrom, senior, forward.
Dom Thomas, I'm a junior, and power forward.
Noah Dahlquist, junior, center.
Taylor Medina, I'm a junior and a forward.
I agree with Coach Reinholt. There's some progress being made this year.
You know, we don't want to cash in the season yet. We don't want to look past the season. But if you allow yourself to look at what's coming for the Rochester guys, finally, there's some length there that we haven't experienced in a long time.
And let's not forget, you get to piece classes together. Sometimes you get wrapped up in, you know, as being a grade. But when you get to high school, you get to combine classes, which you got to take that into account, too.
So the tip is actually tipped out of bounds by Luke Kennedy, and LaVille's going to get it. 3 seconds gone in the game. Tony Stasiak, I'm David Musselman. So Berger will bring it up the floor. He'll run the point for LaVille. Sends it to the near side to Gertner. At the right elbow to Baker. Baker holds the basketball. Top two, Kapetsky. Kapetsky with Cam Screen in his face. Out top of the key to Gertner. Gertner drives it right side behind his back. Dribble goes to the left side. Picks up his dribble against Rochester's man-to-man defense. Kapetsky, top the key to Baker. Now left side to Gertner. Back to Berger. Berger drives it left. Goes to the basket. Throws up a shot off the glass and good. LaVille strikes first. And you could tell why in the pregame show, Coach Reinholt was concerned about Blake Berger, and he is good off the dribble.
Yeah, just following some scores and watching the South Bend News highlights. There's some games where Berger's been regularly in the 20s and even the low 30s sometimes.
So Rochester commits a turnover on the traveling by Luke Kennedy, and LaVille has a back up 2-0 with 7:05 to play in the opening quarter here at Rochester High School. Gertner high on the left side, backdoor pass is tipped away. Picked up by Kapetsky, and he puts up a shot, and I believe he's going to be fouled on the shot, and he'll go to the lane to shoot two.
Foul's going to be on Carter Screeton. Good read. Taylor Medina, Alec Garrick had the lob read very well. Coach Reinhold's thinking, hey, you know, we had the over-the-back call there on us, but Sievers didn't get the call, and then a foul on the loose ball.
Kapetsky makes his first one and pushes LaVille out to a 3-0 lead. One more coming for the junior. Betsy's second one is good again. 4-0 LaVille. Rochester bring it up the floor, going to our left. Screeting across the timeline right against the man-to-man defense. In the paint, cut off by the defense, outside to Kennedy. Tough pass to handle, grabs it before it goes out of bounds, right in front of the LaVille bench. Couple of dribbles down the baseline to Holland. Holland down low to Garrick. Reverse layup is going to be no good, but a foul coming on LaVille, and that's going to send Alec Garrick to the line to shoot two shots.
Foul is going to be Aish.
Isaac Aish.
His first, team's first. Good play by Alec Holland to drive the baseline and for Garrick to cut to the opposite block where he was wide open.
He makes the first free throw. He'll have one more. 6:44 to play in the first quarter. Garrick's second on the way for Rochester is no good. The putback by Medina is no good. And Medina tries to save her going out of bounds, and he does so. Actually, off the leg of LaVille, it's going to stay with Rochester baseline right underneath their own basket.
Great hustle play on a free throw. Just keep the loose ball alive and then go get it.
Well, he made a couple of plays at Southwood that only an athlete makes. So he gets a pass inbounds to Kennedy, drives the baseline, get past to Holland, fakes the three, drives the left baseline, gives down low to Kennedy. Now we're going to have a foul on Holland. It ran over Baker of LaVille, and it's going to go back to the Lancers. And Brandon Camp will come into the game for the first time tonight, a 5'8 senior for Rochester, and Holland will sit. 6.5 to play first quarter. LaVille up 4-1, and the Lancers with the basketball going to all right. Berger right through the center circle, now left side to Aish. Aish then has his pass stolen by Camp, and then he is fouled on the way to the basket. by Gertner. It'll be out of bounds to Rochester.
We've talked about Brandon Kemp being an energy guy off the bench all year long. There's a perfect example. Come right off the bench, read a pass, get a steal, and draw a foul. Could have been a layup.
You know, we've talked about how important it is for that sixth game guy or the first guy off the bench to understand his role, and it looks like that Kemp has done that here in the season.
He's just going to turn it over for the second time on a travel.
And for the first game, their first time tonight is Jason Breeden. And sitting down is Aish. 6:15 to play in the first quarter. Lavelle up by three. Berger works it to the left side. Gepetsky. Out to Gertner. Swings the right side to Berger. Behind his back, dribble on the baseline. Loses the handle, picked up by Kennedy. Turnover Lavelle. Rochester runs down by three. Streeton, top of the key. Left side to Kennedy on the wing. Back to Streeton. Fakes a three. Drives it. Travels. Second possession in a row that Streeton has submitted a travel. And Lavelle going to get it back.
Talked about trying to take care of those turnovers. So far, not a good start. We've played 2 minutes, and the Z's have three turnovers.
Yeah. Seems to be the key for everybody. Kemp steals it again. Kemp will go to the basket against Gertner. His layup is good.
From basket number two.
And it's 4-3. Lavelle runs. Berger through the center circle. Sets up the offense against Rochester's man-to-man defense. Left side to Kapeski. Now to Baker. Baker holds against Kennedy. Still holding. Now to Berger, right wing. Berger against Gehrig. Fakes the three. Drives in the lane. Dump pass down low to Baker. Layup is good. Nice look by Berger. You got to respect that three-point shot. When he gets you thinking he's going to shoot, he fakes and drives and gets an easy bucket for somebody else.
That's a sign of great players. They make other people better. He attracts so much attention. You've got to help in, and he made unselfish good pass right there.
Kennedy misses a little baby hook. Good look. Just couldn't get it to fall. And now Lavelle has it running up by one with 5 minutes to play in the first quarter. Baker. Kapinski. His three is short. Streeton is the rebound. Is crushed out of bounds. And I think that's a good call by the official out here on top instead of the official down low. I think that was the right call.
You know, I was watching the NBA game last yesterday. Well, no. It was the Bulls and Lakers, and they had Steve Javy, longtime NBA official, as the third person. And it was really neat because he was explaining a lot of what officials saw. And he made that exact point, how sometimes you say, oh, you were the closest guy. Sometimes you're too close to the action. You can't see that. You need that trail official to get a better view of the entire play. I think that's the case.
And you've heard some officials say, I can't call that. I'm up top. I saw that the other day, in fact. Kemp down low. Her jumper's no good, but a foul coming on Kapetsky. And that's going to send, beg your pardon, Abbott to the line to shoot two shots.
One of the things the Zebras are doing is not settling for jumpers tonight. Getting the ball inside. That's the fourth team foul by Lavelle. Zebras continue to attack inside. You're going to get Lavelle in foul trouble. They got to be a little tired. They just played Saturday night.
Abbott's first free throw is in and out. No good.
Of course, when you get the free throw line, you got to take advantage of that. Know that feeling a little bit. Not tomorrow, though.
Not tomorrow.
Not tomorrow.
Okay, 90% tomorrow?
Whatever it takes.
Second free throw, no good. And the rebound is hauled down by Lavelle. Lost out of bounds. They're going to say that Abbott strips it out of bounds and going to be last touch by Lavelle. So Rochester will keep possession down low.
Turnover filled the first quarter. Six combined, three for each team. Here, 4 minutes, not even 4 minutes in.
Yeah. Abbott quickly to Holland, who's back in the game. Holland top of the key. Gives down low to Gehrig. Gehrig is fouled on the shot. He'll go to the line to shoot two, and Baker picks up a foul.
If the game plan is to attack the basket, the Zebras are doing an outstanding job. Not settling for jumpers, going in strong, drawing two defenders and trying to finish with through contact and at least draw a foul.
Alec Gehrig at the line for two for Rochester. First one on the way for the seniors, short. 6-3, Lavelle. And back into the game is Breeden, and coming out is Baker with two personals.
As we said, Zebras are doing a good job getting the free throw line, but so far they're 1 of 5.
Garrick's second one, and no good again, and the rebound to Breeden.
I was trying to do the reverse kiss of death there. You know, usually when they're going well and you mention it, they miss. I thought maybe if I'd mention that, they'd get a hot roll.
It didn't work, did it? Yeah. Berger outside to Aish. His three is no good. Kemp skies to the board and grabs it. Now we're going to have a foul and a reach in.
Man.
And, yeah, that's the 16th foul by LaVille, so Rochester shooting from here on out in the half.
And that's going to be the second Lancer with two fouls.
Checking back in with the Zebras.
Two starters, Alec Baker and Cam Dirtner for LaVille, each have two fouls already, and we haven't even played half
the
first quarter.
Right. 4:15 to play in the first quarter. It's 6-3 LaVille. Rochester the basketball. Holland walks it through the center circle against the man-to-man defense. Down low to Kennedy. Kennedy on the block. Goes to the basket. Throws up a shot over the defense. Too hard. And we're going to have a foul on Kennedy for coming over the back. And we go back to LaVille.
It's one of those things, you like the aggressiveness, but you got to understand where the offensive player is at in relation to you. He had you blocked out, and you want to go after it, but you got to live to fight another day. Now, the thing, big thing for Luke is you can't pick up that second one here quickly.
You know, we worked with that about all the first half of the season, keeping the big man on the floor, and as of late, he's been doing a great job of doing that. Berger around the defense, in the paint, loses the handle, picked up by Abbott. Rochester the basketball, runs to our left, down by three. Abbott, left side of the floor, accelerates in the paint, jump stop, outside to Camp, fakes the three, passes up, now to Kennedy. Kennedy in the paint, fakes, pulls up from the free throw line, shot short, and Gertner the rebound for LaVille. Behind his back, dribble through the center circle, down low. To Breeden. His shot is blocked by Kennedy. The putback by Aish is no good. And Medina grabs the board. And then Aish knocks it out of bounds. It'll go back to Rochester.
Really impressed with Brandon Kemp's defense on Berger. He's really just been a pest. Gertner's can't get around him like maybe he tried to earlier on Holland or Screeton. Brandon's been able to stick with him the entire time.
We're down to 3:20 to play in the first quarter. LaVille by three. Rochester the basketball. Kennedy in the lane. Turnaround jumper quickly from 10 feet. It's too hard. Abbott with the rebound. Abbott in the lane. His leaner on the way is short. And Petsky with the rebound. Gertner outside left to Berger. Accelerates in the paint. Outside to A. She'll fire another three right side. No good. And the rebound to Abbott. Abbott runs for Rochester. Zebras with the numbers. Abbott right side of the floor. Moving the paint. He travels. And LaVille going to get it back after another Rochester turnover. And Baker comes back into the game. And Kopensky coming out.
I'd say definitely the Zebras look a step or two quicker overall. I mean, you get that. It's just out of the routine for the guys. They're not used to a Monday game as it is. And when you just played on Saturday night, and the Zebras are at home, got to take advantage of maybe those fresher legs.
So LaVille with the basketball going to our right. Baker feeds down low to Gertner. Gertner, a couple of dribbles to Berger. Wide open three, left wing is in and out. No good. Rebound fall for. Baker with it. Put back, no good. H has it. His put back off the window is good. And LaVille goes up by five at 8-3. 2.5 to play in the first quarter. Holland, left wing with the basketball. Gives to a cutting Kennedy in the lane. Turnaround jumper's long. And Berger with the rebound. And Luke Kennedy just picked up foul number two.
That's it. Again, you just got to know your foul situations. You know, I think he got frustrated. He's missed a couple shots that he felt he should make, and he just hip-checked underneath the defender a little bit there.
And, you know, it's a frustration foul.
Yeah, it's a frustration foul, but, you know, need him on the floor. The Zebra's getting really small now. You take Luke and Medina off the floor. I guess you can make the argument you got five guards on the floor. I don't know I don't think you have a traditional post. Maybe you have it, but
yeah, you're right.
These don't maybe dial up some pressure, or at least extend the defense a little bit.
They have dialed up the man-to-man pressure. You're right. The Gertner holds at the volleyball line. Out of Baker, the right elbow. Baker holds against Garrick. Feeds on the block to Aish. Aish now pulls it back outside behind Arch on the right wing. Looking down, little Baker. Good defense by Garrick. And his pass is knocked away. Treating Caesar from going out of bounds. Feeds it down low to Rochester's basket. And then Baker hauls it down for LaVille. Quickly to Aish. Aish in the lane. Backs his way in. Tries to make BQ with the pass. And it's tipped away. Garrick has it. His jumper is no good. Way off the mark. And then the pass, the outlet pass is almost saved from going out of bounds by Abbott. Gives to Berger. Berger in the paint. Goes to the basket. Right-handed layup is good. Timeout, Rochester. It is a 30. You're listening to Zebra Basketball, 92.1 WROI.
Get smooth one coat coverage and a lifetime warranty when you buy paint at Enert's True Value Hardware Store, 1619 Main, Rochester. Choose Easy Care Ultra Premium Interior Latex Paint with excellent one coat coverage and easy cleanup, or Weatherall Ultra Premium Exterior Latex Paint with stain resistance and great coverage, and get great savings. Find everything you need for your paint projects plus expert local advice at Enert's True Value Hardware Store, Monday through Friday, 7 to 7, Saturday, 7 to 6, Sunday, 9 to 5. Enert's True Value. Start right. Start here.
Zebra Basketball, WROI.
A minute 33 to play in the first quarter. LaVille now out to a 10-3 lead. And Rochester will have the basketball after Blake Berger basically, Tony, went the length of the floor and laid it up.
Yeah.
And
feel Coach Reinhold's frustration. That he just kind of beat everybody down the floor. I mean, there's one thing if you get a turnover, you don't get a call, but you got to get through that. Somebody's got to pick up the ball and stop the ball, especially when it's the other team's premier player who's at the top of the scouting report.
Right, exactly. Carter in the lane, kicks it out to Garrick. Three, left baseline. Good.
Trying to get a three in the flow of the offense, a drive and a kick. You know, try to go inside when they collapse, then get your drive and kick threes.
Rochester been stuck on that three mark for a long time, and probably about 2 or 3 minutes, I'm guessing, and Garrett got him off of that with a big three to cut the lead to four. 60 seconds to play, first quarter. Kopeski to Gertner. Gertner on the left baseline against Holland. Now to Berger. Berger against Camp. Right wing pass to Aish. Aish fakes right, goes left. Back to Gertner. Gertner in the paint. Rises up over Garrick. His jumper's no good. And the rebound to Aish. Straight away three. Top of the key is good for Aish. And it's 13-6. 35 seconds to play in the first quarter. Holland on the right wing. Top to Garrick. Fakes the three. Drives in the paint. Goes off the window. It's good.
Nice job by Garrick. When you hit a three, defense comes out. Use the shot fake. Drive around. Keep attacking the basket.
20 seconds to play, first quarter. 13-8, LaVille. Lancers of the basketball going to our right. Aish to Berger with 14. Berger holds with 13. Drives to the left side, now switches directions, top of the key with 9. Berger at the 10-second line with 8. Gives off to Gertner with 4. Back to Berger with 2. Berger at the buzzer, 3. Off the back of the iron, no good. After one, LaVille leads 13-8. You're listening to Zebra Basketball, 92.1 WROI.
Shepherd Chevrolet Buick in Rochester is the place for all of your automotive service needs.
I've been coming to Shepherd's for service approximately 5 or 6 years. My husband drives the Honda 2004, I believe, so it isn't brand new. And he brings it here. We get our tires here, oil changes, whatever needs to be done, they take care of. We have a good history with the Shepherd family, so we're happy to come here.
For over a century, Rochester Telephone Company has been connecting our community, family to family, friend to friend, business to business. It is the people of RTC, your friends, your neighbors, who have made the difference. Times may have changed, but our tradition of excellent service still remains in our family of dedicated employees that serve you. RTC, a part of Rochester's past, present, and future.
Zebra Basketball, WROI.
Go to the second quarter here at Rochester High School with LaVille leading 13-8. Boy, I got to pass along this score. The middle school, Rochester Girls Middle School, went to Winnemac tonight in a tight one. Fell to the host Lady Warriors, 24-22. Good game. They're now 3-3. Seventh grade was a good game as well. Winnemac won that one 15-14. So Rochester starts the basketball in the second quarter. Kennedy back in with two personal fouls with the ball. Now it's loose. We've got a scrum. It's going to be tied up, and LaVille going to get it.
That was a scrum. I mean, if we were playing rugby, they would be impressed with that.
You know what? You know what we're missing right now?
The Olympics.
Curling.
Is that on?
Yes.
LaVille.
Maybe John can give us a play-by-play during breaks with the curling action.
I'm sure that'll be a ratings.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, I'm sure it is. Berger, right side against Garrett. Crossover dribble, top of the key. To Gertner, to Aish. Aish for three is good, and that's his second in a row, this time from the left wing. And puts the Lancers up by 8 with 40 seconds gone here in the second quarter. Left side is Garrick. High on the left side for Rochester. Drives into the paint. Kicks in the corner. Now we're going to have a charging foul on Alec Garrick. I tell you what, Tony, this worries me just a little bit. I've seen this movie before, that things start getting a little, they get a little frustrated, and the wheels just kind of fall off early. We've seen this before.
Yeah, you appreciate the great effort, but the great effort has to come with the smartness of kind of understanding where you're at. I mean, you can run through a brick wall, doesn't mean it's the best play. Sometimes if there's a ladder next to it, you just take it up and go over it. But in this case, you can tell these guys want the game really bad. You just got to play within yourself. Try not to make too many great things. Attack the basket, but attack it under control, and if it's not there, kick it out.
Speaking of that, Creighton did that outside to Holland, high on the right side to Kennedy in the paint. Backdoor pass to Creighton. Layup is good. Good look for Kennedy. Good finish for Creighton. And the lead is cut to 6. LaVille with the basketball. Kopeski travels, going to the basket. Rochester going to get it back. after the first couple of minutes. Louisville hasn't done that a whole lot here in this first half. 16-10 Lancers. 6:35 to play in the first half. Basham is in the game for the first time for Rochester. Gives to Holland. Long three is no good. Ball being tipped around. Kennedy has it. His put back over the off the rim is no good. And the ball being tipped around. LaVille saves from going out of bounds right in the hands of Berger. Berger runs middle of the floor. Hesitates. Goes to the basket. Foul on the shot. He'll go to the line to shoot two.
I think that foul's going to be on Garrick, although it could have been on about three different Zebras. Foul's going to be on Garrick. That's his second. So Zebras, Garrick, and Kennedy both have two. Kennedy's back on the floor with two. He's going to have to really be careful about what he does. Struggling from the field, but he can't let that affect his defense. And he's got to play smart. He's got to stay on the floor. His coach is trusting him as a senior with two fouls.
Correction, that was a non-shooting.
He was not shooting. Lob pass comes into Berger to Aish. Three on the way, right side. Draws nothing but air, but an offensive rebound to Gertner. Gives to Berger. Right side to Aish. Aish with screen in his face. Kopetsky, one dribble to Berger, left wing. Backs it out. Resets for LaVille. Top of the key. Now works high on the right side against Medina. Back to Aish. To Berger. Berger drives around the pick. Over the top of the defense to Kopetsky. And the three by Aish is no good, but on the rebound, it comes a foul on the Zebras.
And the foul is going to be on Basham. And we're going to have a free throw contest here the rest of the half. Both teams are shooting with 5:48 left in the second.
Here's what impressed me on that last drive by Berger. He hesitated, yet didn't carry the basketball, mm-hmm. and was able to accelerate through that.
Use that hesitation dribble as long as you keep your hand on top of the basketball. You can use that quick little hesitation.
You know, it felt like him to me that he just kind of held that basketball there for a couple of seconds and then decided what he wanted to do and bang, going to the basket. So the first one by Breeden is good. He'll have one more for LaVille, looking to push this lead back to eight. Second one on the way, that's no good. And the rebound is Creighton.
Medina gets a block out to the three-point line. Clears out the path, and Screeton gets an easy rebound.
Screeton in the corner to Holland. Three on the way, left baseline's off the back of the rim. No good. Rebound fought for. And Kopetsky comes out of there with it. Gives ahead to Berger. LaVille runs. Gertner near side. Goes to the baseline. Cut off by Screeton. Out to Berger on the right wing. Stands behind the arc against Camp. Now accelerates in the paint. Rises up over the defense. Shot no good. Offensive rebound to Gertner, who dribbles out and makes that to Berger. Gives to Gertner right side. Out to Kopetsky. Back to Berger. Left side to Aish. Another three for Aish. This one's no good again. The putback by Gertner is no good. And the ball is tipped out of bounds by Rochester. And it'll stay with LaVille.
So far, the scouting report given to me by Coach Reinhold today on LaVille has been rock solid, dead on. No post game. Have you seen a post feed yet? Nobody has posted up. They've gotten some passes to block off the layups, but I've yet to see anybody post up on a block or give them the ball posting up on the block.
Aish is checking it from behind the arc tonight, doesn't he?
Yeah.
Gertner, down low to Aish. Aish puts it off the glass as Kennedy comes flying by him. And the lead is 9 for LaVille with 4:50 to play in the first half.
Aish having a big night. He's got 10 already.
Holland right side to Medina. Stands top of the key to Camp. He feeds down low to Kennedy against the triple team. Kennedy out to Streeton. Fakes a three. Drives it. Gives to Kennedy just inside the arc. Left baseline is short. And the ball is knocked out of bounds. Last touch by Medina. LaVille going to get it back as Abbott comes back into the game and Streeton to sit. We'll do a little sectional preview coming up at halftime.
Okay. Camp has a defense assignment on Berger. I've been really impressed with what he's been able to do. He's been the one Zebra who's been able to keep kind of Berger in front of him. Now the Zebras have to find an answer for Mr. Aish.
Well, you know as well as I do, if you're guarding the best player, you're going to run through about 7 picks or 7 screens each time your team has the basketball. Berger, 18-footer right side, off the mark, no good. And the rebound for Medina. Medina then will bring it up himself, right side of the floor, crosses the timeline. 4:05 to play in the first half. LaVille by 9. Camp drives the baseline, throws up a shot, it's good. Nice strength by Camp because Berger was hanging on the basketball and Camp still got it to go.
Just a great athletic move. He's got such quick steps and quick front straight line burst that's a great move.
Which is probably why he's guarding their best player.
Right.
Aish, Kopetsky. Gertner now right side to Berger. Berger against Camp on the wing. Backs his way inside the three-point line. Now pulls it back outside. Between his legs, dribble. Works left. Outside to Aish. Aish top of the key against Medina. Left side to Berger. Three over Camp. Good.
LaBelle basket.
And now LaBelle up by 10. Abbott quickly to the baseline. Gives to a cutting Kennedy. Jumper no good. The putback is good. 22-14, LaBelle. 3:15 to play in the first half.
That's Luke's first basket. Let's see if that can't get him going.
That'd be nice. He's, like I said before, he's had a lot of good looks. Just can't get him to fall at this point. Berger against Camp. Between the rings now. Now left side of the floor to Gertner. Gertner holds against Holland. Now directs traffic. Now drives it right. Back to Berger. Fakes a three. Drives it just inside the arc. Jumper's long. But Ace with the rebound for LaBelle to pick. Kopetsky is fouled on the shot. He'll go to the line to shoot two. So active.
Yeah.
Zebra ball.
Foul's going to be on Medina. That's his first. Zebra's eighth. That's one thing, you know, just scrappiness. The Zebras have a height advantage on the floor, but, you know, LaBelle keeps sending four to the boards very aggressively. And sometimes it just takes one guy to not block out to get an offensive putback. Yep. And then, as I always say, 95% of the times you get an offensive rebound, there's a foul coming in somewhere probably.
Kopetsky, second one is no good. Good block out by Basham. He grabs a rebound and gives to Holland. 2:45 to play, first half. 9-point lead for LaBelle. Rochester with the basketball. Holland left elbow. Gives him the right corner to Camp. Camp back to Holland at the volleyball line. The right wing. Down low to a wide open Abbott. Abbott off the window before the shot. He's fouled. He'll go to the line to shoot one in the bonus.
Zebras have done a good job of looking for that cutter underneath the basket. That's about the third or fourth time the Zebras have kept their head up and passed to a baseline cutter right wide open underneath the basket.
Ace picked up his second personal foul, and Baker, who has two for LaBelle, is back in. Also back in for Rochester's Alec Garrick.
Well, that's one way. If you're struggling guarding a guy, get him in foul trouble on the defensive end, then you don't have to guard him when he's sitting on the bench.
2.5 to play. First half, Abbott makes his first free throw. He'll have one more. Tony Stasiak, I'm David Musselman. First half coming to a close here at Rochester High School. Abbott will have one more free throw for his Zebras. Looking to cut this lead to 7. Eyes the second one, lets it fly, and it's good again. Nope, they're going to say wave it off. He was over the free throw line before the ball got to the rim. I think we've seen that maybe twice this year out of all the games we've done.
You know that counts as a turnover as well?
I don't know if I knew that, but it doesn't surprise me.
You
really.
Do now.
I do. I'll forget by tomorrow. Full court press by Rochester. Right side to Gertner. Gertner around the defense, top of the key. Picks up his dribble and against the trap. Finds a wide open Kopetsky. His three on the way is good. Good heavens.
That's a 2-2-1 half-court trap. And one of the things that the Cardinals send the Zebras, they let the dribbler dribble back to the middle. And once that ball goes back to the middle, then you quick reversal, he was wide open.
You know, to this point, Tony, I think LaBelle sees the floor really well.
Yeah, I mean, with no post-game, they're just kind of spreading the floor. And, you know, if you send two at a guy, they're just unselfish enough to make the pass. Or, you know, they'll do the skip pass if you overplay. I think they just have a good understanding of the game of basketball, which shouldn't be a surprise when Jack Edison's your assistant coach and Michael Edison's your head coach.
Well, I was going to say, I think that the coaching staff, you know, we've seen it before when these two guys were at Plymouth. If the score is 15-14, I think they'd take that.
Mm-hmm.
Medina makes the first free throw. As Kopetsky picked up his first second foul, but here in the second half. And the
second quarter.
We're not in the second half yet. Medina's second one is no good. Rebound to Basham. Basham down low is fouled on the shot, and Baker just picked up. Well, we'll see who that's going to be whistled against. But Baker took one to the nose.
Lancer foul number 23.
Darvin Kopetsky. His third. Coach couldn't get him out soon enough.
Number 20.
Which is big because Kopetsky's just the one that hit the three. He's got 6 points.
Basham for two. First one is no good for the senior. One more. 26-16, LaBelle. And with 2 minutes to play in the first half, Ace back in for the Lancers.
The free throw line has been quite costly to the Zebras.
Yeah.
They are now 3 of 12.
Medina grabs the rebound on the block, puts it back up, foul the shot, good to foul!
That's always good if you can get the offensive rebound off a missed free throw and draw a foul in the process.
Lancer foul number 44, Isaac Ace, shooting one.
And even bigger, Mr. Ace just picked up
right.
Three.
So now you got two of the five starters with three personal fouls here in the first half.
And those two guys have combined for 16 points.
Medina completes the three-point play. It's now 26-19 LaVille. A minute 50 to play in the first half. Oh, my goodness gracious. And I believe Silk Camp going to pick up the foul. I thought maybe they're going to whistle that against Abbott. And that's going to send a Berger to the line to shoot two free throws for LaVille.
At the line in double bonus.
Yeah, that's always interesting when coaches decide to go there. And, you know, from speaking from experience, but kind of interesting is LaVille had a lead, and you put your two starters with two fouls when you have a lead at the end of, you know, with a couple minutes left in the second quarter in a non-conference game, unless you want to see if guys how guys can react to that in a non-conference versus a conference game.
But Stace, take a look at the bench. Take a look at their bench. They're a little shy. I mean, you have to do that because you have to do that.
Yeah.
Two free throws by LaVille were good. Now it's back to a nine-point lead for the Lancers with a minute 45 to play in the first half. Camp, left wing, travels, going to the basket.
Who made those last two free throws?
I think it was Berger.
Was it Berger?
100 seconds to play. First half, 28-19. LaVille on top. They've got the basketball going to our right. Berger with the basketball across the timeline against the trap. Kind of dribbles out of it. He got in a trap and he travels. Good pressure by the Zebras.
Yeah, like I said, I've just been so impressed with Camp's defense here. He's always been in the right spot. He's got that strength. Berger's skinnier than he is, so Berger can't push him off. He can hold his ground, but he's also got the quickness to stay in front, too.
Kennedy and Holland back into the game for the Zebras. Basham,
I would think,
and Camp.
I think this is probably offense for defense if they can, knowing that the Zebras have the ball, telling Luke, don't get a charger over the back, but try to get him in the game on the offensive end. If there's dead ball, get Luke out.
So Rochester with it going to our left. Streeton high on the right side to Holland. A minute 20 to play, first half. Holland to Kennedy. Luke drives it right. A couple of dribbles cut off by the defense. He too in the double team. Out to Streeton now. Streeton around the double team to Gehrig. Gehrig works the left side. Lob pass down low to Kennedy. Luke to Holland. Holly now feeds in low to Medina. Medina jump stop, pulls up, good. Taylor Medina has two more, and the lead is cut to seven. LaVille with the basketball in the lead.
Medina's got six this quarter.
That time he posted up and was begging for the ball.
Exactly what the Zebras needed with not much else going offensively to get Medina 6 points. Those have been huge this quarter.
28-21, LaVille, as the second quarter coming to a close here at Rochester. We're down to 38 seconds.
Ooh.
Gertner feeds down low to Aish. Aish puts up the shot. He's fouled. He'll go to the line to shoot two.
You want to talk about Riverboat gambling? Aish is in the game now with three. I mean, what if he, you know, pick up a charge?
Oh, yeah.
And all of a sudden your leading scorer's got four.
Yeah.
Lancers shooting two.
The quarter's not over yet.
Yeah, and you have,
and there's somebody coming in for him.
Okay.
Aish with two. Eyes the first one. No good. In and out. Abbott back in. Gehrig will come out.
And
Kennedy will stay.
Yeah, unfortunately, Gehrig picked up that third foul, which coach didn't want.
One more for Aish. Looking to push this lead back to eight for his Lancers. Second one is no good. Kennedy with the board. Gives a Streeton with 30. Streeton across the timeline left with 29. Where's Keith Kirtner?
Could go at Aish. I mean.
Yeah. Give it to Abbott.
Yeah.
Who was guarded by Aish.
Give
20 seconds.
Get out of the way.
Medina fakes the three. One dribble out to Abbott with 15.
Go.
Abbott drives it left side in the paint. Jump stop. Outside to Kennedy with 10. Now to Streeton with 9. Streeton holds with 8. Streeton drives it right with 7. Streeton backs his way to the free throw line with 5. Gives to Abbott, and he travels, going to the basket with 3 seconds.
He had the right thought. I think he was thinking of driving quick, but feet went a little too fast for the ball.
Camp back in, and Kennedy will set with 3 seconds to play in the first half. So Aish will look to get it in. Aish around Streeton. Lob pass into Gertner. Gertner with two. Gertner from the volleyball line as the buzzer sounds, and it's no good. After one, LaVille leading 28-21. You're listening to Zebra Basketball, 92.1 WROI.
At Shepherd Chevrolet Buick in Rochester, it's our customers that come first.
The sales process was very simple, very easy. It's a very nice and friendly atmosphere. They've always worked with me on my trades and what I bought. There wasn't any haggling. It's where I really wanted to be, and I would keep coming back.
Stop out today and let Shepherd's help you find your next vehicle. RTC makes it easy with the new Triple Play Combo. Now you can enjoy the best of cable, internet, and phone for one low package price. Get all of the features that they want at a price you can afford. The Triple Play Combo, another great offer from RTC. We all want to do our part to help the environment. With RTC, when you go green, you get green. When you sign up with RTC's e-bill online payment system, you can save $2 off of every bill. Just log on to RTC1.com and click on the e-bill icon. No stamps, no envelopes, no worries. Go green, get green with RTC's e-bill.
First Saturday, that was good for us. I don't think you'll see that kind of game, but still, I think it got some kids some confidence that need it.
Sure. Well, good luck tomorrow night, and we'll talk to you before that game.
Looking forward to it.
So the Zebras will start the third quarter of the basketball. Garrett goes to the basket, kicks it out to Streeton at the baseline. Streeton cut off by the double team over the top of the defense of Medina. Medina, one dribble to Holland, right side. Holland throws the basketball away right into the hands of Baker. Now quickly to Berger. Berger, middle of the floor for LaVille. 7-point lead for the Lancers. Again, as we start the third quarter here at Rochester. Baker, Kapetsky, now to Aish. Top to Gertner. One dribble. Oh, back door to Kapetsky. His layup is no good. But rebound fall for. Garrett comes out of there with it. And now to Holland. Rochester runs down by 7.
See if there's some adjustments. Fouls were a big factor. And there's 3 people on the floor that have 3 fouls. And now Ace just picked up his 4th, I believe, if my numbers are correct, which they're not always guaranteed to be so. But it's 4th. And that's a young man that has 10 first half points.
Yeah, that's a big call right there for Rochester.
It was a tough matchup for the Zebras. And you would think he'd be spending extended time on the bench with 4 fouls here early in the third.
So 50 seconds gone here in the third quarter. Rochester down by 7. Screeton directs traffic, goes high on the right side. In the corner to Medina. Taylor, a couple of dribbles, back to Screeton, top of the key. He drives to the free throw line outside of Holland for 3. Good!
3 points, Zebra basket number 3, Alex.
I know you talked to Coach Reinhold. I heard his post-game Friday night, and, you know, need to get Alec Holland going. That's a good sign. I know he had, 11 points Friday night.
Yeah.
You need him to be somewhere around that double figures mark each and every night to give the Z's a legitimate outside threat.
And he's kind of been cold in this basketball game, but, you know, what do you always tell your shooters? Just keep shooting. Berger rises up in the paint, throws up a tough shot, misses it, and Garrett grabs the board. Alec Garrett quickly down the floor, gets away with the carry, I think. Right side to Streeton. Streeton in the paint. Down low to Garrick. Garrick backs his way in. Throws up a shot. It's good. Rochester cuts the LaVille lead to 2 with 6:20 to play in the third quarter. Kapetsky for a 3 is good. Wide open 3, and he buries it.
Just kind of lost in transition there.
Streeton out to Garrick for 3 is short. Kennedy, the putback is no good. And the rebound to LaVille and Breeden quickly. Kapetsky loses the handle. Out to Gertner. Leaner. And we're going to have a block. Wow. I thought Kennedy had a position, and Gertner ran over him and got the call.
Foul's going to be on Luke. That's his 3rd. Kind of one of those where didn't get that. LaVille wanted the offensive foul on the other end. No call there, and Zebras won the offensive foul here, and block call goes LaVille's way. Gertner makes his 1st free throw. That's his 1st points of the game.
One more coming for Gertner. Second one short. Garrick with the board.
Corner!
Garrick quickly to Holland, left side. Holland to the elbow, kicks it out to Streeton. Rochester then resets. Streeton dribbles around Berger at the center circle, drives it left at the paint. Now to Kennedy. Wrap around pass to Garrick. Layup is good.
Number 24,
a post-to-post pass there. 2 more points for Garrick.
Garrick's in double figures with 10.
32-28. LaVille on top. Gertner in the paint. Outside to wide open Baker for three. Nope. Put back by Berger. Yep. Grabs the rebound and in mid-flight puts it back in for two.
That's a good play because when you're a little guy, you don't want to bring the ball down and have to go back up.
Yep. He did it well there as he pushes this lead back to six for LaVille. Medina holds at the top of the key. And he drives. Jump stop out to Holland. Holland on the wing. Works against Gertner. Looks back door to Streeton. Can't find him. Now to Garrick between the rings. Left side to Kennedy. Works against Baker in the man-to-man defense. Around the defense. Ooh, travels. Yep.
He's looking for Garrick on the roll. Garrick didn't get quite an easy release. Held up a little bit by the LaVille player, and Luke dragged his foot as he was waiting on that roll from Garrick.
34-28 LaVille, under five to play in the third. Brent Abbott will come back into the next opportunity for the Zebras as Baker has it. To Breeden, quickly to Gerton, now right side to Berger, back to Baker. Baker, one dribble to the left side, back to Berger. Blake Berger drives the baseline, throws up a shot, it's good. That's a tough shot, and it goes. And after the shot, he kind of looked around to see where the foul was at. Back to an eight-point lead for LaVille.
Berger now has 13.
Kennedy gets the entry pass from Streeton and loses it out of bounds. So Abbott comes back in, and Garrick will sit down.
Garrick had been guarding Berger. You wonder if rotate a fresh body, put Abbott on him for a little bit. You got Camp, who I thought did a pretty good job in the first half. Maybe rotate some fresh bodies and try to give Berger some different looks that way.
Braden has his pass stolen by Kennedy. Kennedy, right side of the floor. Kennedy, leaner off the glass, no good. Fought for the rebound. He gets it back. The putback is no good. The putback is good.
From basket, number 40.
Kennedy, kept fighting. And finally got the bucket to fall to cut the lead to six.
I see him keep working at it, and he did so without going over the back or committing a foul.
Berger, you're right. He's being chased by Abbott, and now Abbott's going to be called for the foul to the dismay of Coach Reinholt.
Foul's going to be on Abbott. Looks like Abbott had established his guarding position, and sometimes you don't always have to draw a foul or fall down to draw a foul. If the offensive player initiates the contact, that can still be a player control foul.
So Abbott picks up another foul. LaVille keeps possession. Gertner on the left baseline against Holland. Outside of wide open Berger for three. Nope. But an offensive rebound, and Breeden is fouled on the shot. He'll go back to the line to shoot two. Boy, you got Berger to miss the shot. And then we put a body on Breeden.
Number 35, Jason Breeden.
So Breeden at the line to shoot two shots. Breeden, a 5'10 sophomore, connects on the first one. He'll have one more.
His first point of the night.
I've never seen so many different looking style of shoe on a basketball team. Second by Breeden is short. Kennedy the rebound. Not one of them match.
Yeah, colors or styles or brand.
Yeah. So the pass is at the feet of Abbott. Can't save it from going out of bounds, and it's going to go back to LaVille, up by seven. 3:35 to play in the third. Tony Stasiak, I'm David Musselman. Non-conference and a rare Monday night game in high school basketball. Of course, when you have 15 snow days in January, that tends to happen. And now we're going to have a foul down low on Camp as Berger went hard to the baseline.
Camp's picked up two quick fouls. He's got three now. The Zebras have four here in the first 5 minutes or so of the third quarter.
3:25 to play in the third. 7-point lead for LaVille. The lob pass comes into Gerton. Back to Berger. Now to Gerton high on the right side. Drives it left. Cut off in the paint. Outside to Berger. Quick three. Quick release. Short. Rebound to Berger. Berger feeds down low to Baker. Baker against Kennedy. Has a block from behind. And now Berger is going to pick up another foul.
I think it's going to be Baker.
I got a feeling today's Kennedy's fortunate he to pick up foul number four.
Yeah,
or maybe three.
It would have been Kennedy's fourth. Zebras got away with one. Cardinal Sin did not block out Berger on the original shot. Gave up an offensive rebound. Zebras fortunate they missed the putback. Maintained possession.
Garrick back in. Medina to sit with 3:11 to play. In the third quarter, 37-30. LaVille on top. Rochester the basketball. Dean Hubbard in the house.
Yeah, look at that. Yeah, you got to figure probably a kind of a slow night. I don't know. how many games there are tonight.
Oh, Gehrig puts up a circus shot and rolls over the front of the rim and goes.
Got 12. He had 6 in the first quarter. He's now got 6 in the third quarter.
Cuts the lead to 5. Berger accelerates around the defense. Goes up, foul of the shot. He'll go to the line to shoot 2, and Alec Gehrig just picked up another foul for the Zebras.
Heady play by Berger. You know, Zebras coming down, just get back in a hurry, and you can tell he's not just a shooter or a driver. He's a scorer. He's got good understanding of his body angles and where he needs to go. In that case, to draw a foul.
Berger with 2. First one is good for the junior. We'll have one more
because Garrett just picked up his 4th.
Checking back in with the Zebras.
Taylor Medina back into the game, and Rochester will use a timeout. It is a 30. You're listening to Zebra Basketball, 92.1 WROI.
Fulton County Best One Tire is so much more than just tires. They offer a complete line of service with quality you can depend on. Ask their friendly staff about an oil change, transmission flush, brake service, alignment, or even an engine replacement. Or stop by and see their experts about a custom exhaust. They also keep the area's largest tire inventory in stock. Right now, you can take advantage of great rebate programs. Just call Doug or Todd at 223-2103. Fulton County Best One Tire. Tire, where the most important person to them is you. They're located at the corner of Fort Wayne Road and Highway 25 North in Rochester.
Zebra Basketball, WROI.
2:45 to play in the third, 38-32. LaVille on top, and Berger with one more free throw.
You made the first one, correct?
Yes.
Okay.
The junior eyes the second one, lets it fly, and it's good again. 7-point lead for LaVille. 2:40 to play in the third. Streeting through the center circle. Man-to-man defense by LaVille. I don't know if we've seen anything but man-to-man tonight by both teams.
Correct. Yeah, both teams just...
And Breeden...
be another foul. Imagine that.
Is going to be called on the reach-in, and it's going to be out of bounds for Rochester.
His first. Team's third.
Breeden.
As you're at that point of the season, guys, team two, you're kind of playing kind of somewhat vanilla.
Kennedy gets a lob, inbound pass, and tried to put it up before he came down and couldn't get it to go. Another good look, can't finish. Baker then blocked by Kennedy. Get out of here! And then picked up by Streeton and runs it right. Streeton at the elbow, kicks it out to Kennedy right side. Luke at the elbow right, gives to Medina. Medina goes to the baseline. Kind of a push-off, gives to Streeton now, top of the key to Kennedy. Straight away, 3, wide open, off the back of the rim, no good. And the rebound to Gerton.
I'd say unofficially Luke's got to be about 2 for 11, 2 for 12.
Yeah, he's struggling tonight.
But he has not let it affect his defense.
Gerner loses it on the way up, makes that Berger loses it on the way up, and Kennedy with the rebound. And Luke will be the guard now. He goes up to Streeton.
Nobody else is going to wait for him. He doesn't really have an option.
Streeton backs his way in the paint, spinner in the way. No good. Gerner with the rebound. And he slows up and gives off to Berger now. 7-point lead for LaVille. And Abbott tips the basketball out of bounds. Right in front of the LaVille bench. And it'll stay with the Lancers with a minute 37 to play in the third quarter. LaVille by 7.
It's one of those tricky areas the Zebras have had trouble with at times, knowing when to push the ball but take good shots. You know, you want to pick up tempo, but make sure you're taking good shots, not forced rush shots. It's not been the Zebra style. I think they're trying to use their well-rested legs, more so than LaVille to their credit, but you got to get good looks on the other end.
Another offensive rebound by LaVille. As Berger missed the 3-point shot again, he drives it right against Abbott. Pull-up jumper from the free throw line is no good. Another offensive rebound, and I believe Paker just picked up another foul. I thought Kapetsky was going to pick up a foul and probably should have on the last shot.
Baker's 4th.
Minute 17 to play in the third. LaVille by 7. And in the game for the first time is Greg Peppers, a 6'1" junior. 6'1". That's going to be a typo.
Maybe it's the shoes. Maybe he's got some lifts in his shoes. You know, who knows what? I mean, you've got every color of the rainbow and every design.
Actually, those kind of match one of somebody else's.
Maybe he forgot his. He had to borrow. Somebody's second pair. Maybe they have individual shoe contracts.
You know, if the team was baby blue, then I can understand the shoes. I just don't get it.
My socks don't even match.
Gertner with the basketball. Ball loose still on the floor. There's another scrum. Somehow LaVille comes out of there. Kapetsky. Oh. And we're going to have a timeout. LaVille. LaVille's going to get a timeout. It will be a 30. You're listening to Zebra Basketball, 92.1 WROI.
Your Fulton County REMC is proud to offer the new Faster Exceed satellite internet service. They can now connect customers to their fastest satellite internet service ever with broadband speeds up to 12 megabytes per second. For homeowners with fewer options for internet service or who live in rural areas, there's no better option than Exceed Broadband. Share photos remarkably fast. Enjoy better video chat with less jitter. Send and receive files quickly. Exceptionally fast web browsing and email. Listen to streaming music. If you're ready for a faster internet connection, you're ready for Exceed Broadband. Call 574-223-3156 today to learn more about the amazingly fast Exceed Broadband service offered by your local Fulton County REMC, your Touchstone Energy provider.
Zebra Basketball, WROI.
46 seconds to play in the third quarter. LaVille up by 7 at 39-32. And after LaVille timeout, Berger has the basketball walking through the center circle. Rochester in a half-court trap. Gertner against the sideline. He gets it out to Breeden, and he is fouled by Basham. And I believe LaVille will shoot free throws. No, maybe not. One more.
That's it. Yep. Just got word from Coach Joe McCarter, the freshman victorious tonight.
Good.
Couldn't remember the score, but he said it's comfortable.
What do you mean he couldn't remember the score?
Said maybe 50, what? 35, I don't know.
Was he there? Hey, he coached it, didn't he? Berger against a double team, runs away from it. Now the skip pass. The Gertner has it stolen away by Holland. Holland, a breakaway layup right off the glass. Is no good, but a foul coming on LaVille. That's going to send Holland to the line to shoot two. What a tough call to make. I mean, all three of them were trailing the play.
Number three.
That's going to be Gertner's third. LaVille's fifth of the half.
Number three.
Alec Holland going to go to the line. Try to work on. He's made 1 3-pointer for his only points of the night.
15 seconds to play in the third. And Holland misses the first one.
It's the Zebras' first attempt of the second half from the free throw line.
Say it again.
First attempt of the half.
Okay.
They only made, I think they're 3 of 12 from the line in the first half.
Second one's good this time by Holland, and he'll come out of the game and back in his camp. 15.1 to play in the third. Rochester down by 6.
Big possession here. You don't want to give up a 3 or a 2 at the buzzer. And you can manage it going in. Just to such a momentum deflator when you're kind of making a run and give up a late basket.
Berger runs over the defense. The official wanted to call it. He put it up with 3, with 2, with 1, and that's going to do it. After 3, LaVille pushes the lead to 8. You're listening to Zebra Basketball, 92.1 WROI.
Shepherd Chevrolet Buick in Rochester is the place for all of your automotive service needs.
I've been coming to Shepherd's for service approximately 5 or 6 years. My husband drives the Honda 2004, I believe, so it isn't brand new. And he brings it here. We get our tires here, oil changes, whatever needs to be done, they take care of. We have a good history with the Shepherd family, so we're happy to come here.
We all want to do our part to help the environment. With RTC, when you go green, you get green. When you sign up with RTC's e-bill online payment system, you can save $2 off of every bill. Just log on to RTC1.com and click on the e-bill icon. No stamps, no envelopes, no worries. Go green, get green with RTC's e-bill.
Zebra Basketball. WROI.
Fourth and final quarter here at Rochester High School. The Zebras trailing by 8 now at 41-33. And Tony, you said what you said couldn't happen happened as the time ran out in the third quarter.
Yeah, and not only that, but then LaVille gets possession, first possession of the quarter. That's a double whammy, especially if they're able to score off that.
LaVille has been up by double digits maybe once early in the second quarter. Rochester's been able to keep it close. Here is we go on here. We go into the third quarter, and Berger is fouled. Going to the basket by, I believe, Camp. And that's going to send Berger, who has been automatic from the stripe, to the line for 1 in the bonus.
Yeah, a foul is going to be on Camp. He is 4th. Team 7, so there's other things. LaVille's been able to attack the basket, draw fouls. They're shooting free throws the rest of the way, and they've been very good from the free throw line.
Free throw.
Well,
free
there
throw
you
go. Berger is no good.
Kiss of death works once. The other thing I was going to say is there's probably going to be a point in time, if this is a typical Edison team, of they'll get very deliberate can play keep away, and so you can't afford to get down too far.
Yeah, well, with 30 seconds going up by 8, we might see that here before long, but before too much longer anyway. Camp holds, looking down low to Kennedy. Can't get it to him. Good defense by Breeden. Streeton makes that to Garrick. Backs his way in. Throws up a shot over the defense. No good. And the rebound to Peppers and LaVille. Gertner quickly ahead. Petsky outside to Peppers. One dribble to Gertner. And they'll reset to Berger. Berger around the defense to Gertner in the center circle. He holds. Couple of dribbles. Middle of the floor. Left side to Peppers. Peppers against a double team. Works around the double team to right side. Kopetsky, the double team, is stolen by Kennedy.
Nice job. Zebras trapped out of their man-to-man for a run and jump.
Streeton for three, left baseline, short. And Kopetsky with a rebound. And now we're going to have a travel on Breeden, and it will stay with Rochester.
If the Zebras can keep attacking the basket, you know, a couple more fouls, they're shooting free throws the rest of the half, and they've struggled from the line. But if you can still get there and have a chance to score with the clock stop, that's big.
Absolutely. You're right. Lob pass comes in to Camp near the timeline. 6.5 to play in the game. 8-point lead for the Ville. Camp rises up in the paint and gets it to go. 41-35.
Good elevation on that shot, too. That's one other thing that kid can do.
He can jump. You're right. Gertner crosses the timeline, drives it right, runs into Berger. He has it with the basketball over his head. Bounce pass to Gertner. Tries to get it down low, does so to Peppers. Outside to Breeden, jumper good. Sophomore Breeden gets it to go and pushes the lead back to 8 for LaVille with 2 minutes gone in the fourth quarter. Carter Streeton holds. Lob pass to Kennedy on the right wing. Kennedy drives to the free throw line. Down low, ball tipped away right in the hands of LaVille, and it's going to be tied up with Breeden and Streeton. Rochester will get it back baseline right.
Yeah, the play was open several times in the first half. LaVille's kind of taken that away. They sagged a little more inside the lane and able to get a deflection and knock the ball out of bounds.
I think
H and Baker back into the game, both playing with 4 personal fouls. Streeton will look to get it in.
Still like to attack the basket, get an inside move here.
Kennedy, power dribble, puts it up. Good. 43-37.
Luke should live down there. There's no matchup they have for him.
LaVille gets it across the timeline. Kopetsky fouled about 20 feet away from the basket. I believe Kennedy's going to pick up a foul. At least look.
Nope. It's going to be on Basham. I say, hopefully not Kennedy, but Basham will pick up his third.
Kopetsky at the line to shoot one of the bonus for LaVille.
Kopetsky.
With LaVille leading by 6. First one's good. 44-37. Again, 5.5 minutes to play in the game. One more coming for the junior.
Double figures with 10.
Second one's no good. Kennedy the board. Luke gives to Streeton. Streeton through the center circle. Gertner awaits him with the volleyball line. Nice screen by Garrick. It was called illegal. Turnover, foul on Garrick.
And that's going to end Garrick's night. Unfortunately, he's going to finish with 12.
With Zebras number 12, Taylor Medina.
Medina will replace Garrick. 5:20 to play in the basketball game. Gertner around the defense in the center circle. Works high on the right side. Crossover dribble to Berger on the near side. Berger around Medina. Gives it back to Gertner. And Basham is going to pick up foul number 4. And Gertner will go to the line to shoot one of the bonus.
Basham seems like he's averaging about a foul a minute. He hasn't played a lot, but he's got 4 fouls. He's trying to be aggressive, but there, you know, you got to wait and let your help get there. Medina was coming over. Let the offensive player make the mistake. You had him trapped. Don't bail him out by bodying him up and hip checking.
Yeah.
Back on the floor with the Zebras number 3.
Free throw's good. It's 45-37. Holland back in. Basham to sit. LaVille with an opportunity to push this lead back to 9 with this freebie. Gertner eyes it, lets it fly. Good again. 46-37. LaVille on top with 5:15 to play in the game. Streeton works to the right wing. High on the right side. Baseline to Holland. Holland against the double team. Back to Streeton on the right wing. Streeton drives it left at the free throw line. Out to Camp.
Camp fakes about a thinks of a three, and then the pass goes inside to Kennedy. We're going to have a foul on LaVille. And so after the next foul, we'll have send Rochester to the free throw line for the rest of the game.
Berger's first foul of the night. One of the few players who spent any kind of decent time on the floor that hasn't picked up a foul.
They come in bunches for LaVille in the first half. Holland for three off the back of the iron. Nope, Kennedy with the board, loses it to Aish. And then gives ahead to Berger. Berger against Medina, but Berger goes to the basket. A lot of contact, no foul. And Kopetsky couldn't save from going out of bounds. Good heavens. Berger got lit up. 4:40 to play in the game. 46-37. LaVille on top, Rochester the basketball. Screen through the center circle. Gertner waits for him. Sends right side to Camp. And his pass is stolen by Berger. Berger against Holland. Finger roll off the front of the rim is good. And now LaVille back up by double digits of 11 right now with 4:20 to play in the game. Holland top of the key. Berger gives to Medina. Medina back to the way in and travels.
Mr. Berger, after a slow start, now has 19 in the evening.
Yeah. I would have never guessed that.
Hasn't scored in bunches, but he's just kind of been consistently there. Every few trips down the floor, ball ends up in his hands, and he usually does something good with it, for LaVille's sake at least.
Yeah. 4 minutes playing the game. 11-point lead for LaVille. Gertner against the double team. They're going to have to use a timeout. Nope, they give it to Aish. Left side, Kopetsky. Back to Aish. Now high on the right side to Gertner, who holds and gives back to Berger with 3:50 to play in the basketball game. LaVille by 11. Gertner against Abbott. Here comes a double team. And now Gertner runs over Holland and is called for a charge.
Gertner's fourth. Nice job. That's a call you only get if you're reading and anticipating. And Holland was. He got to where he could see that he was going to come his way. Got his feet set and drew the foul.
It's the only way he could go.
Right.
You know, he had sideline on one side and a 10-second line behind him.
Yeah, that's a well-executed trap.
3:35 to play in the game. 48-37 LaVille. Holland to Medina at the volleyball line, center circle. Now to Abbott. Abbott drives into the baseline. Cut off by the defense and the double team to Holland. Alex to Kennedy. Jumper from the elbow. No good. The putback by Medina is no good. And Berger with the rebound. Gives the head to Baker. Baker right-handed layup is good. And now we're going to have a timeout. I think Gertner lost a contact. I don't know what the rule is anymore, but I thought that they got Medina that time for slapping the backboard.
I think it was Kennedy slapped it, actually.
Oh, was it?
Yeah.
Okay. And now LaVille will use a 30-second timeout. You're listening to Zebra Basketball, 92.1 WROI.
Get smooth one coat coverage and a lifetime warranty when you buy paint at Enert's True Value Hardware Store, 1619 Main, Rochester. Choose Easy Care Ultra Premium Interior Latex Paint with excellent one coat coverage and easy cleanup, or Weatherall Ultra Premium Exterior Latex Paint with stain resistance and great coverage, and get great savings. Find everything you need for your paint projects plus expert local advice at Enert's True Value Hardware Store, Monday through Friday, 7 to 7, Saturday 7 to 6, Sunday 9 to 5. And your True Value. Start right. Start here.
Zebra Basketball, WROI.
LaVille leads 50-37. After a layup by Baker, we have 3:17 to play in the basketball game here at Rochester.
I would say LaVille's probably going to get fairly patient here, even by their standards.
I mean, 13-point lead, I think they're right. A lot of basketball this week on WROI. Of course, tonight, the guys here with LaVille tomorrow night, we're on the road to the Rochester Lady Zebras as they open the sectional play at John Glenn. Thursday night, we're back home with Wabash, the guys in Wabash, and then Saturday afternoon, the Rochester guys will play Wawa C for the first time, maybe ever, and Abbott is going to be called for a travel. And if it isn't ever, it's been a long, long time since Rochester's played Wawa C.
Yeah, they're the replacement for Warsaw.
Same conference, different team. Gertner, wraparound pass to Berger. He loses his footing and the basketball. Kennedy has it. 2-on-1 break. Kennedy will go all the way to the basket. Finger roll's good. Lead is cut to 11.
You know, I'm not well versed in the NLC, being a Doonland Conference lad myself, but wouldn't Rochester play Wallace in the old NLC, maybe?
Yeah, you're right, but that was, what, the mid-80s? Aish, layup, good.
Wentzer basket, number 44, Isaac
I don't know if Paul Ossie was even there in the 80s. 39, make that 52-39 Wawasee. LaVille with 2:15 to play in the game.
It is a Monday for everybody.
See what you're doing. Creighton out to Kennedy. Three, right baseline. Short. Kopetsky with the rebound. And he'll push ahead to Berger. 2 minutes to play in the game. Aish thought about a three out to Gertner. To a wide open Baker. Layup good. 54-39, a minute 50 to play here at Rochester.
It's going
to
be one of those games that's going to look at the final score a lot different than the way it was played out.
Yeah, in the last 3 or 4 minutes as well.
It feels kind of like our Wabash game from Thursday. You look at the final score and...
Creighton leaner off the window is good. I don't know how Creighton got the ball, but he did.
Loose ball, paying attention, picked it up and scored.
So... LaVille with the basketball, and he's fouled by Medina.
Gertner's going to go to the line where he's 3 of 4.
Eddie Pfeiffer just sent me a text, and he said the last time we were in the NIC, 86-87.
Oh. Like I said, I'm well-versed on Doolin Conference
right.
History. Not quite yet so much here.
And so Wawasee was in that as well, Eddie? Second one is good as well by Gertner. It's 55-41 LaVille with a minute 15 to play in the basketball game. Streeton dribbles to Medina, top of the key, a minute 10. Abbott in the paint, outside to Medina, drives it right, jump pass outside to Streeton, three right baseline, nope, and the rebound to LaVille. Yeah, Wallace was in the NIC then as well, and Rochester was there in 86-87. Berger down the middle of the floor. Layup is no good, but a foul coming on Kennedy. And that's going to send the junior Berger to the line to shoot two shots. This is LaVille Lancer team leading 55-41.
It's going to be Luke's fourth. Berger going to go to the line, try to reach the 20-point plateau with this one free throw.
First one good.
Checking in with the Zebras, number 30.
Mashing back in, and Kennedy's night is over with 53.8 to play in the game.
Luke's going to finish with 4 of 15. I'm going to put it unofficially.
Second one good again. Berger's done with 21 points, and Pepper's back in. Screen will bring it up the floor. 50 seconds of play in the game, 57-41. LaVille on top. Straight in the right side.
So here's one for you. How much more impressive does that Winamac win at LaVille look now?
Yeah.
Yeah. I mean, we knew it was a good win, but I'm pretty impressed with what I've seen from LaVille after just playing Saturday night. Creighton for two. Drives in lane. Hits a pull-up eight-footer.
30 seconds to play in the game. Kopetsky to Aish. Gertner to Peppers. 20 seconds. Aish. Kopetsky with 15. Kopetsky holds against Medina, and now we're going to have...
Wow.
A foul on Taylor Medina.
Number 12, Taylor Medina.
So, I guess back in the day, you know, the NIC consisted of Bremen, Warsaw, Wawasee, Concord, Plymouth, Goshen, Rochester, and Northwood.
Okay.
And, of course, the only one not there now, two of them not there now, is Bremen and Rochester. NLC, I'm sorry.
Number
the NLC.
Jacob Williams, number 20.
And, of course, NSC, that, you know, you got that big conference blow up coming down the road, the NSC and the Midwest, and it'll be interesting to see the shakeout of everybody's schedules when you've got all those moving parts
of
two conferences, and then what happens with the likes of Bremen, who's out there without a conference right now.
Well, and what happens if Peru McConnell will join us?
True, yeah. There's a lot of interesting moving parts here. Would not.
Streeting at the buzzer. Good. The final tonight goes to LaVille, 59-45. You're listening to Zebra Basketball, 92.1 WROI.